This is DIFF 5. We've just had round 13 moving into round 14. I'm TJ with
Darcy Evans.
And back by popular demand,
Shaun the DIFF Jacobsen.
He is our DIFF 5 expert. So, firstly, thanks to all our great sponsors. Just plugging away, doing the right thing behind us there. Make sure you support them if you can. And we're going to start with last week's results. And I know you watch the show every week, mate. We'll start with your game so you can give us a bit of a feed on it. Get right into it, we get all the details. None of us, now let's put it out there because we're very honest, we stand by our tips and so forth, and despite the fact we've got over 7,000 years experience between us, I got 2 out of 5, I think you got a 2, and Paulie got a 1 last week, and this is one of the ones we didn't tip because Colonel White Gardens were top going into the game, but it was Rosewater 12-11-83, Colonel White Gardens 9-10-64, just go to the major goal kickers. For Rosewater, it was John Stone with 2, Murray and my boy James Taylor, both sexual and intellectual. Whilst Francis kicked 3 for Colonel Light Gardens. Best was, how do you say that one there?
That's a smooth Gafreda.
Smooth Gafreda. Sharp, Williams Foster and JT as well. Tell us a little bit about how Bolton played, because it's a big upset.
I was a bit surprised with how well we played. Having our second best there, Jared Shah, playing helped a lot. It's first game for the year, big Ruckman back, so he gave his first use of the footy all day. And yeah, smooth, Grafada, done an absolute.
Is that where that comes from?
He took his nickname from his brother, who's a league footballer.
Yeah.
He just took it for himself, thought he was a better one than Zoo, that's why he's playing DIFF 5 football.
Yeah.
But he got the job on Harvey, and he's only about a 5'10". Weighs about 60-70 kilos, and yeah, took Harvey to the cleaners.
Harvey, you helped goals, was he?
I think he kicked 1 goal.
Yeah, he did, he snuck in with 1.
Yeah, he's done a fantastic job on Harvey, and yeah, everyone played
any
pretty well.
Any trash talking on Harvey? You ever think about telling him he spells Aaron wrong?
I was down to full forward anyway, so I was down the other end. So yeah, me and him went real well. Yeah. I didn't.
You had a big day, didn't you?
Oh yeah, three points.
1 goal, 3?
No goals.
According to the paper, you kicked a goal, so you might want to get on board that.
No, it was my younger brother who kicked that goal, so I can't take his credit, even though I want to.
What's his name? Chef after
you? Scott, how was Chef?
He's always grumpy.
Yeah, older grumpy, yeah. He said, let's move on to it next week.
Yeah,
asked if we could go to recovery. I told him, no chance, mate. We tried to get him to go to Red Square. No, he wasn't budging.
Chef at the Red Square. Pointing his fingers.
That was crooked finger. Billy Bowden, I'm quite finger.
It certainly does. All right, now that's a huge one, mate. And let's get on to the other results. So, you see these teams regularly. Any surprise to the fact? I'm surprised at the fact they only kicked 2 goals. We South at home, 2 goals, 8-20. CBC Old Collegians, 18-14, 1-22.
Not too surprised by school lines, considering how the conditions were, so that's probably about right.
100 points. Are they are that far off the pack?
They're very far off the pack. Yeah. We've got to play them again, so I shouldn't say too much, because in case they do get competitive against us, but yeah, they're a fair way back.
And I mean, at this stage, you don't want to get too far ahead, so there's a fair chance. There's a chance you could play CBC in that first week of finals.
Very big chance. If we can knock them off this week, and Barry was getting knocked off this week, so there's still a chance of third. But yes, I think we're about 2.5 games behind them.
I'd throw to you for an opinion. You didn't get anything right this week, so.
No,
you've got not a lot to offer. Just quickly, again, Puccini kicked 4, Harris kicked 3, Ford kicked 3, Madigan best for CBC. Just to be fair to Woody South, because they are doing it tough. Summer and Hanson popped up with goals, and special mentions to Ridgeway, Daly, Economy, Gosling, and Binion, who are battling it out down there. I'll be in that position where you're getting flogged each week. And it's happened to me in football teams as well, but that's another story. It's going to spit a comedy there because Paul's not here. All right, next one. This is a very important game. This is one of the ones I actually did get right. It was Blackfriars, Old Scholars, 14-12-96. Elizabeth, 9-11-65. I'm on the wrong page. Hillman kicked 4. Richardson and Brincat and Murphy all got doubles for Blackfriars, with Horsell and Brincat being the stars. Whilst for the opponents, it was Stuart Shaw and Northcott as the standouts, with Webber kicking 3, mate. This one was tough to pick. We ummed and ahed over this one.
I would have probably gone Blackfriars just because it was at their home ground, but I thought the result might have been a little bit closer, but yeah, Blackfriars are, like I said, sitting top for a reason, I guess.
Yeah,
but did give you a bit of breathing space too, because they did win that game. They were pretty good.
Yeah,
very good win.
Yeah, I was very glad.
Nice little segue there, mate. You're looking at the ladder, so just that does Black Friars top, the battle for fifth and sixth, but gee, the next result tells a bit of a tale, doesn't it? So tell us, who's in seventh there, mate?
So it's Green Acres.
Green Acres, yes, 1.5 games behind.
And they're doing ninth at the moment.
So, yeah, 1.5, are they? So they're 2.5 games behind your mob now, and we thought they were a real danger team. At home this week, it was the Green Acres, 10-8-68. Adelaide Lutheran 11-13-79. Now
that did this.
Yeah, no, and that look, that Lutheran, they've started to come good, but unfortunately so have Pulteney. So let's just go over the details of that one. It was Schofield and Ty Allen, who's always in the best players with the goal kickers, with three each. Clark Rantasic did his job for Green Acres, kicking five, but not enough mates out there. Allison Borges and Greeky best for Lutheran, while Clark Rantasic deservedly best for Green Acres. Mate, the Green Acres thing surprises me, because when they're a bit of the old the downhill skier type syndrome, or the flat Indian cricket pitch where you can make 100 at a moment. They're just flat track bullies.
Yeah, I'm surprised about the result as well, but yeah, like you said, Lubri's starting to come good. Gone into another year since they look like getting relegated, but yeah, maybe it's a little bit too late for them, yeah. I reckon, yeah.
Two games.
Especially with Pulteney in another weekend, though, yeah. I reckon they might be up there, maybe six.
Yeah, absolutely. And the next one, again, another upset. Upset to plenty. It was Pulteney, 9-6-60. Parahill, 7-8-50. And we're taking a bit longer on the results here because they're just interesting and surprising. Ace kicked 3, no surprises there, with Reed kicking 2. Barris, Trigg, and Kursop were best for Pulteney. Whilst for Parahills, and Parahills haven't lost too many, Noyne kicked a couple, and he was also their best player. So, yes, interesting set of results there indeed.
Very.
It is nice to have 10 teams in here.
Yes, anyway, even though I wouldn't want to buy some of these.
Well, you get one of you. If you could please, kind sir, would you take us through the Darcy Evans goalkeepers?
Yes, indeed. We've got James Clark. Now, this gets me every time.
Fantastic.
Van Tasseron, 52 goals from Green Acres. Aaron Harvey, not far behind, on 47 from Kernelight Gardens. Peter Smith from Green Acres on 45. Paul Cree from Parry Hills on 40. And Kristen Puccini from Christian Brothers, CBC on 36.
Well, mate, Adelaide Uni boy. Probably out of all of them, probably the only real small forward, genuine small forward, so he's done well there at the pooch. He's bobbing up every week.
He is.
He's twos and threes and fours.
First time.
But my question is for the DIFF. Who is the best raw forward talent in the league?
Probably Aaron Harvey.
I really thought you were going to go with you then.
I wouldn't have liked to have used me.
He's always up there. He's always up there. Oh, yeah. Every year he's up there, so
yeah. He's not too bad.
You can't see. Yeah,
no.
How many goals you kick for you?
Not many. About 11 or 12, 20.
Double figures, mate.
Yeah.
Do you have to scroll down?
I do. I know.
No, War and Peace.
That's all good.
We've done the ladder, we've done the goal kickers. Let's get on to this week's games. Here we are, of course, talking about round 14 in Division 5 with our expert, Shaun Jacobsen. It's Parry Hills and Green Acres at the Paddocks. You got your ladder back. You have Parry Hills are in third, Green Acres are in seventh. Based on what I've seen last week, I'd expect Parry Hills to be up there.
Yes, so would I. I reckon, well, definitely, especially their ground. I don't reckon they've lost the game at their home ground all year. We played there 2 weeks ago there, and they were very good. I can't see them losing. I reckon they'll win by 6+ goals.
Exactly what Paul Manuel says, or Manuel as we call him. Parry Hills won't lose at home, so I don't think Darcy will disagree with you.
Parry Hills, yeah.
Now, I know sometimes it's hard to spot and identify names from other teams, but Paul Cree, has he jumped out here for Parry Hills?
He's a very lean lad. Remember, I think he bagged free against us a few weeks ago. The lad that stood in played pretty well, but Hanson as well was pretty tough one up there for him. He's a big, solid unit, so he's another tough one to match up on.
Decent footballers, no doubt. Adelaide Lutheran, South Parklands take on Elizabeth. Elizabeth, they have to win if they want to play finals. They can't put it off. Kerry Payne is the master coach. We talk about him all the time. I'm going to tip Elizabeth. I'm going to get your tip and then we'll go to the expert.
I'm tipping Elizabeth. Again, they have to win. They're one game on Rosewood. They're in fifth. They have to win. Adelaide Lutheran, are in the second bottle. They are coming good, but I still think Elizabeth by coming.
They've certainly been better over the last month, Lutheran. Are we far off the mark?
I think Elizabeth will win, even though I really like Adelaide Lutheran to win, just so we can get more breathing space.
Yeah. And where does Ty Allen, was he been floating around?
When we played him, he was sitting around the middle or just kick behind the play, sort of loose in the fence. And he just racked up positives against us that day.
Yep.
One of the reasons they got the draw against us.
Yep. And Elizabeth have been good this year, if not maybe a bit inconsistent. I hear that's through injuries. Yep. Stars for Elizabeth?
Weber up full forward. He was pretty good against us.
Yep.
Ollie, as they call him in the midfield, was their best player when we
big
played.
Big long chopper.
Yeah. Then two were probably the best. I'm not even going to attempt to pronounce his name.
Next one is Blackfriars and Woody South. It's top versus bottom. It's Blackfriars at home by how much?
You're going to have an ugly day, Woody South, I think, unfortunately.
No, I only kicked 2 goals last week at home, so they've got problems up forward.
So I reckon Blackfriars by be well over 100 points.
So they're going to walk the park with them.
just they've been conservative here, I think. Woody South may give a bit of aggression, you never know. But
I'm not trying to lie, but I'm just looking at percentage. Because percentage
55-30,
you know, there's none of the teams at the top have drawn, so yeah, it's percentage is relevant, and they might go chasing some. Yeah, I'd suggest Blackfriars by plenty of looking inside the South Footy Club. So, Colonel Light Gardens coming off a loss against Rosewater, mate. You've seen them firsthand. Poultney again, they're 5-8. They had that flat patch in the middle, but they've had a good win last week. I like Colonel Light Gardens to bounce back. Who probably need to watch?
Harvey, of course. Chad Francis as well. A couple of them bagged a fair few this year as well. I've got no idea anymore. I wasn't paying too much attention to them. As I said, I was trying to worry about getting a kick and I was struggling all day. So, I reckon, like you said, Colonel Lyle will bounce back and I reckon pretty comfortably as well.
Yep. And the last one is our match of the round. It's CBC versus Rosewater. Probably could have done it before, but give us the score last time you met, mate. You've got it there, haven't you?
Yes, I do. They knocked us off. 14-7 CBC, and we kicked 8-16 at 64, and I probably would have kicked 8 and then moved out.
And points or goals?
No, points.
I wish I so bad kicking was bad. Obviously, it's at East Park Lanes this time. It's huge, isn't it, Darcy? Because they are...
Quite a massive game, isn't it? Rosewater have to win to stay in. You know, there's an obvious answer to that, but I'm going to have to. CBC, they're just probably... They're coming good as well, so I'm still going to go. Look, unfortunately, mate, for CBC out there, a bit of a mumble of an oval.
Yes.
Slightly gluggy out there, I think, this weekend after the rain we've had, so they're probably used to it. CBC by not much.
Yeah, I think at Dolphin Park, I'll be taking the boys in purple as well.
Yeah, if it's pissing down the rain, I might just call up sick if you see the chef. I hate it down there, so.
All right, boys, thanks again for your expertise on DIFF 5, mate, and this has been the weekly roundup. We'll be back next week.
See you later.
See ya.